Dwayne here, PhoenixTypewriter.com. Got electric Smith Corona. This is like a 5TE. This is a tower Smith Corona. Well, Sears Smith Corona electric tower. Let's see if I can get some focus on here. I know it's out of focus. Okay, and got here is a wreck of a machine. This thing is had at least 10 links off down here, plus these type bars here. These ones over here, they want them and come back. Type on them and they just, somebody put so much oil in here or something that the segment is just stuck like crazy. So I'm gonna deal with that. I've got a lot of videos that show how to do that, but that's not what we're gonna do today. Today we're gonna look at, let me move this thing over. Just about took my finger off there. The motor clutch here. So I did just get this thing cranked up. I kind of had to self-start it. This clutch should spin freely, and it's not. So it should, it's a centrifugal clutch, so you should be able to hold this, and that clutch will spin and get speed and then engage. But if I hold it, it just doesn't turn. So it starts by starting the whole process. So we're just going to remove this and rebuild this clutch real quick. It's a pretty common deal with these old typewriters that need to be serviced pretty regular and just wasn't. So this has just a couple screw type set screws here. We're just going to remove those. And again, I've got the camera right in my face. I can't see the slot there. There it is. Okay. Find that slot. And let's just take this clutch off here. So this isn't really necessarily the bad piece. These little guys have springs in the centrifugal. It's usually this shaft is stuck on the pulley there, so let's just pull the belt off here real quick and see. There's a fan back here. I can hold the motor. It seems to be turning there, but let's pull this pulley off the shaft here like that. Get this belt out of the way. And then there's a little, another little collar here. Okay, I'm back. Gonna pull this other little plastic collar off here. Just like that. And now we're going to flush this with some lacquer thinner. Something to soak up some of the mess here. I'm just gonna put a little bit of lacquer around here and just kind of clean this whole area up. I don't got my air compressor turned on, so we're just gonna put all we can there. Repeat the process. And again, air dried out. And I'm just going to zap it with the neutral stuff so it's not totally dry. Again, air blow off the excess. That looks pretty good. And now I'm going to put one drop of red oil right on that bearing. And maybe drop on the shaft here and just wipe it in the shaft. So that's got a little bit of lubrication. And now take that little fiber collar here and just give it a little bit of a clean job. We'll use the screwdriver maybe here and just the inside of that, both sides. Just stick that back on. Tighter fit than I was expecting there. Let's see if it. I don't like that. I don't like it that it's that tight. I don't like that. Let's see if this fit on the little file here. I'm gonna file the inside of this down a little bit. I'm gonna do a little more. Better. Let's try flushing this pulley out. Same thing. We're just going to try to get some in the shaft and try to get the inside of this shaft ringed out, cleaned out. You know, the junk that's in there. Gotta get that out of there. Repeat there. Okay, so that's spinning nice and free on the shaft. This guy, we're just going to also flush this. So just got to flush the old oils out of here and put a drop or two of fresh stuff in here. So right on the pivots here would be good. This is going to throw off all the excess anyhow when we turn it on. So all right, to get this back in the right position, I'm going to have to reach in here, and I can hold the motor shaft, and then I'm going to reach the motor, right? Well, I thought I could get to that. There it is. Okay, so we're going to stick this on. And we just want a little bit of side play on this. So I'm going to back it off just slightly. And tighten one of these down. And check it. So I'm looking for a little end-to-end play here. And it is very, very little. I want a little more end play. So, oops. That's too much. Just moved on me, so let's grab the, get him here. And grab that motor shaft, there we go. Let's try it now. Good, so it's just got a little bit side to side. And let's tighten this down. Tight and tight. At least I have to make sure they're really tight. Alright, let's stick the spout back on here and see what happens here. Okay, so this should start up properly this time. Okay, so if I hold this now, the motor clutch should spin first. And it does. So. Grabs it. Good. That's the way to do that. Pretty simple little procedure, but and it's pretty common on these electric Smith Coronas from this era. All right, Phoenix Typewriter, motor clutch rebuilt. Good day.